Hello, how are you? My name is Alejandro Sandoval, and this is the Solo Negocios video blog for July the 9th, 2018, with the Solo Negocios bulletin summary for today. The peso got depreciated this time after a whole week of appreciations, and this was due mainly by profit taking in the foreign exchange market. The Bloomberg dollar spot increased in 0.08%, and the trade war, there were considerations over less tensions, although the tariffs imposed by the US last Friday are active and the retaliation by China is active also. But Trump stated that he might not impose tariffs over automobiles against Europe if Europe eliminate their tariffs that were put into retaliation and previous tariffs existed before. And well, he's kind of negotiating, so that's why the markets more or less gave ease on this situation or perception of the tensions in this trade war. But also there was profit taking in the whole markets, because given that last week we had all markets going down, specifically stock exchange markets and this type of foreign exchange markets, well, given the profit taking scenario, many markets improved. But we will see if these tensions are really easing up or increasing in the following days. The UK now has some political crisis, given that there are resignations from the foreign affairs minister, and the Brexit negotiations taking place there, or how the UK will face the Brexit negotiations. Europe is awaiting, but actually they are having problems internally to make it easier. It seems that Theresa May, the current prime minister, looks forward for a semi-Brexit instead of the full Brexit voted 2 years ago in that country. And well, now they look for a lesser intrusion of the government in them in terms of exiting the European Union because of the conveniences that is to belong, you know. Mixed oil, given the Iran sanctions imposed by the US, also that the capacity of oil production by OPEC members and allies will not be met. I mean, they're supposed to compensate those production processes that will not be existing after the sanctions are imposed. So if that happens, then the question will be if OPEC will be able to increase their production enough to compensate that situation. If not, we'll see rising prices in oil, but right now they're mixed because of that situation. In terms of internal situations in Mexico, Mr. López Obrador, the president elected, had a meeting with Concamin, which is the business organization for industries in Mexico, manufacturing processes, and they had a good meeting. It was open to public, or at least to press, so they reported a good meeting. In terms of NAFTA, the potential group of people in charge of this type of deals and the economic minister for the following president for the following term had been stating that they see the probability to have a sign on this NAFTA deal, the NAFTA 2.0, before December 2018. Banco de Mexico's exchange hedges were demanded 2.05 times more than the $200 million offered for 60 days, and this implies a lesser volatility. Actually, in the market specifically, we had 108 pesos average spread in banks, which implies a diminishing of 2 cents from Friday, but a continuous diminishing for the whole week, for the whole past week, which implies also less volatility. Support 19 pesos per dollar, resistance 19.50 per dollar in the wholesale market, and the futures for December 2018 improve in 0.86% compared to Friday, and they are at 19 pesos 55 42 cents per dollar. So this whole situation is converging the graphs downwards. Specifically, those for 30 days are clearly downwards, and for the interbank exchange rate, looks increasing in the 12 months position, mainly due to the April hike that we lived and until June 15. Well, from June 15 to today, almost a month, it seems downwards very clearly. So after the 12 months measurement is looking upwards, we perceive that this will be raised soon if things keep steady in terms of internal economies and also in terms of the situation with trade war, if it diminishes, and NAFTA also diminishes. Anyways, external elements are still more important to this exchange market, exchange rate market, than the ones internally created. Anyways, another mention is to consider the debt for the new government. It will be greater than any other debt registered in Mexico, the public debt. So we'll see how they handle it, even with all the different promises they have in their agenda. Well, this is what we have for today. We'll see you tomorrow. Thank you very much.